Hey guys, GetLevel here, and today I'm gonna show you how to set up your OBS Studio for recording gameplay. Now in this video, I'm only gonna cover how to record smooth, buttery gameplay footage. If you want to know how to set up OBS for streaming, I have another video on that. And in that same video, I actually go through how you can set up your scenes and your sources. So if you haven't seen it yet, go watch it now and then come back to this video. But right before we start, a quick message from our sponsor. This portion of the video is sponsored by Owned Pro. Owned Pro is an online service and software created for streamers and designed to jumpstart your streaming career, giving you access to overlays, alerts, and other tools for live streamers. Owned Pro is currently available in over 9 languages, and that includes overlays and alerts, meaning that non-English speaker streamers can easily get started with their customized experience. Owned Pro will also give you access to a Twitch chatbot that will moderate your chat and help you run giveaways. They also help you take a good look at your statistics, give you free panels, and even provide copyright-free music. Owned Pro is currently compatible with YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook. Owned Pro is constantly coming up with new features, but I'll let you check it out at own.gg/getlevelpro. That is own3d.gg/getlevelpro. So we're here in OBS Studio. As you can see, I have everything already set up. One little tip that I'm gonna give you is to actually use a different profile when you are setting it up for recording. That is if you also live stream. So up top here in the menu, you're gonna click profile. You're gonna click new to create a new profile. You can call it recording, for example. I'm gonna call this one record. What it's gonna do now is run you through an auto configuration wizard in order to basically predetermine your computer's capacity for recording. So you'll be able to click on optimize just for recording. I will not be streaming. Don't worry, this is only for that profile. You can switch back to your streaming profile later on. Click next. So base canvas resolution is going to be basically the resolution of your current screen. If you have a 4K screen, you want to set this to 4K. Right now we're in 1080p, so 1920 by 1080. FPS 60 or 30, but prefer 60 when possible. Click next and then apply settings. So click on settings. And in the first general thing here, this is where you can set up like your dark mode, okay? If you want dark mode, this is what it's gonna look like. It's Rashneet. So if you see people with different looking themes on their OBS Studio, this is where they change it. I use Acry because I feel like it's the darkest and it's clearer basically for me. You can click apply or just go to the next one. So since we're not streaming here, stream is not gonna impact anything. So here in output, you want output mode up top to be advanced, not simple, so that you will have this extra recording tab. So we're in the streaming tab, go recording tab. And then here we have type standard. Recording path is where you want the videos to be recorded. And then you have recording format. Now, there's a lot of advantages to recording MKV or MOV or FLV because those are non-loss formats. So if your computer shuts down in the middle of the recording, you can still save them. But the problem comes with compatibility. It's not easy to have an FLV file and just drag and drop it into most common video editing softwares. So I usually record in MP4. If something happens with my computer while I'm recording, well, it was meant to be. But it's super easy to record and immediately drag it into Premiere or DaVinci Resolve and all of those softwares. Okay, so for encoder, you can either use Stream Encoder, but in this case, we're gonna pick a specific encoder. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card, I have a 1070, for example, you will want to use NVIDIA NVENC H.264, right? That's what it's made for. It's NVIDIA, right? But if you're running an AMD, you want to use X.264. So we're gonna pick NVIDIA NVENC here. And we're gonna have a bunch of other options. Don't be scared, okay? It's all fine. Just a couple of things that we're gonna modify here. So, rate controlled CBR, this is constant bitrate. That means that your bitrate is not gonna shift during the video, which is amazing if you intend on editing that video. So bitrate, you can go from anything to 10,000 to 20,000. I usually keep mine at 20,000, but depending on where you want to upload it, you would want to look up a guide on what is the best bitrate for that video. I will try to find one for YouTube, for example, where if you're uploading 1080p, usually 15,000 is completely fine. When it comes to the preset, here it says quality, you wanna go max quality. If you have any issues with that, you can change it until it basically runs smoother. Profile, you wanna keep that high and keep the rest pretty much similar. Let's go to video. So in video, you're gonna find something called base canvas. This is what we saw in the auto configuration wizard. So it's your, it's the size of your screen. Now, if you want to downscale while you're recording, you can go to the output scaled resolution here. And if you would like to have your videos be 720p, maybe you're trying to save space on your hard drive, or you're recording the video for purposes where you don't need a full 1080p, this is where you can change it. FPS values, you want that to 60. Downscale filter, you can apply one only if you're downscaling, but most of the time you're not gonna see the difference, although it does tell you what it does. Bilinear is fastest, but it's blurry if you're scaling, etc. I like to keep mine to bicubic sharpen 16 samples. But one thing that I need to not skip is audio. Global audio devices is basically where you're gonna set up your desktop audio versus your mic audio. And this is what's gonna bring them into your mixer. Technically, you're supposed to know this, but maybe you're new to OBS and you're just setting it up for recording. Desktop audio, you want to pick default. That means that anything that is Windows default, for example, your headset, is gonna pick up everything that goes through the headset. So your gameplay is gonna go through it. If you're playing YouTube music in the background, it's gonna pick it up too. So be careful of that. Mic auxiliary audio is where you pick up your preferred microphone that you want to record to. It doesn't have to be the headset mic, so this one is not default, although you can set it to default. If you have a separate mic specifically to record audio, like a USB condenser microphone, I definitely advise you picking that microphone. Then we have hotkeys, which is where in the first hotkeys here, you'll see start recording, stop recording. If you want to set up a hotkey so you don't have to, you know, alt tab back into OBS to stop the recording or even pause the recording, you can set it up here. Just don't use a hotkey that you will use in game, for example. And those are the basics. If I created a scene here for my gameplay, I would just add a game capture. Okay. And then I would pick either capture any full screen application if your gameplay plays full screen, or a specific window. And then in the window tab, the window menu, I will pick the exact game. It will probably show up full screen if you're playing it at 1080p, for example. And that is how you can use OBS Studio to record your gameplay. If you have any questions, you can leave them in a comment section below. You can also follow me on Twitch. I also stream. And if you're looking for a streamer community to hang out with, my Discord will be linked in the description. Actually, you know what? Look at all the links in the description. It's very important. If you're looking for some dope overlays to make your Twitch channel look good, go to gumroad.com/gallevel. And top right, YouTube will show you what they think is the best video you should watch next. At the bottom, you will see my most recent video. Go check him out. Keep on learning about live streaming. And I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud. Gallevel. Out.